Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to 2023 Intake International Information Session of Tianjin University. So first, let me introduce myself. My name is Jun Yao, the admissions coordinator from International Admissions Office, School of International Education of Tianjin University. And today, I will show you through my presentations to learn
About the
admissions
city of
office, School of
Tianjin
International
University, and
Education of
our
Tianjin
international
University.
student
And
policy.
today, I will show
We
you
will
through
begin
my
the
presentation by giving an overview of the city of Tianjin. Then we will move on to the university and the students' life. And then finally, look into our admission policy and application process. With a history of more than 600 years, Tianjin is one of the most unique cities in China, where the East meets the West and the modern merges with the past. Having a population of more than 50 million, the city is lively and embodies the spirit of openness and inclusiveness. As one of the four municipalities directly under the central government of China, Tianjin is the economic center of the Bohai region and also hub for international shipping in North China, and has become a national R&D base for advanced manufacturing, a zone for financial innovation and services, and a pilot zone for economic reform. More than 1,400 foreign
Foreign
zone
aid
for financial
enterprises and
innovation,
nearly
250 Fortune 500 companies settled down in Tianjin. And Tianjin is widely recognized as an ideal place to study. First, it has excellent transport networks. Neighboring our capital city of Beijing, it takes only 30 minutes by roads from Tianjin to Beijing. The city has four big railway stations and three international airports, so you can travel very conveniently by public transport across the country or even internationally. And second, Tianjin is a very exciting place to live. It has a pleasing climate with four distinct seasons, where spring is a season of flowers, autumn is a month of bright moons, summer is never short of breeze, winter is a land of surprise. Tianjin is among the top five Chinese cities that are very cheap to live in and offer a high quality of life. It's also a good place for anyone looking to experience a more traditional Chinese culture than you may find in other famous cities. The four pictures on the right show the landmark sceneries of Tianjin. It is worth mentioning that the Tianjin Eye is the only ferris wheel across the river in the world, which was designed by professors from Tianjin University. Of course, there are many other famous places of interest and recreation facilities such as Huangyaguan Great Wall, Happy Valley, and the Universal Studios. Last but not least, Tianjin has produced some of your favorite Chinese foods like fried dough twists, Chinese-style omelette wrap, gobbly baozi, and others. As Tianjin's premier homegrown snack, all tasty food is a must for every newcomer to explore. And now, let's move on to the second part, why to choose Tianjin University. Established in 1895 as Peiyang University, Tianjin University has a long, impressive history. The following timeline presents all the milestones that TJU has passed on its way through more than 120 years of history. The university was renamed as Tianjin University in September 1951. 8 years later, it was identified as the first batch of 16 national key universities. In 1996 and 2000, it was among the first group of universities under 211 and 95 project of national investment for developing world-class universities. In 2017, TJU was selected for the double first-class university. And TJU plays an important role in modern higher education in China. We created many firsts in the history of China's higher education, such as the first modern university in China, the first Chinese university diploma granted, the first discipline of higher education in China, the first batch of foreign exchange students in China, and the first batch of graduate students in China. Tianjin University also has created many firsts and made an important contribution to the creation of a relatively complete modern industrial system in New China. and turning our attention now to the rankings. TJU is performing very well in both nationwide and global rankings. It is a top 10 university according to 2022 China Alumni Association Chinese University Rankings, and top 50 in US News 2022 Asian University Rankings, and number 232 in the CSSC 2022 World University Rankings. In recent years, with the aim to keep pace with the international cutting-edge academic progress and meet the demands of national strategic deployment, TGU has formed a balanced structure of disciplines with an emphasis on engineering combined with science and integrated with economics, management, humanities, law, and education. The university has 24 academic schools open for international application, and they can be divided into four areas, namely engineering, science, life and medical sciences, humanities, and social science. Then, you may wonder what are the advantage disciplines of TJU? Actually, in 2018 National Discipline Assessment by Ministry of Education, 14 disciplines ranked level A among 25 subjects participating in the evaluation, especially chemical engineering and technology ranked A+. It is worth mentioning that the overall disciplines quality of TJU ranks top 3 in China. Moreover, according to the ARWU Subject Rankings 2021, TJU has 11 disciplines listed in the world's top 50. And nowadays, we are also improving in ESI rankings since 2018. According to the latest statistics, 13 disciplines rank top 100%, especially chemistry, material science, and engineering rank the top 100,000%. And now, let me show you some figures. We have over 38,000 students, 19,000 undergraduates, 19,500 postgraduates, and 3,000 international students from more than 140 different countries. We have a very strong team of 40 staff, with more than 5,040 staffs, and nearly 900 of them are with professional titles. In the year of 2021, about 4.1 billion RMB was applied to the research fund and resulted in more than 2,100 patents. TJU researchers push the frontiers in science and technology by continuous innovation in line with the new global paradigm. And this slide also shows our famous professors and the scientists of TJU. And now, I will introduce some scientific achievements of TJU. The above is National Facility for Earthquake Engineering Simulation, which is the first major scientific and technological infrastructure in the field of earthquake engineering in China and the largest and most versatile in the world. In the middle shows our contributions in Tianwen-1, and in the bottom, you will find the Petro underwater glider, which is applicable for deep sea environment observation. And in 2020, it set a world diving record of 10,600 meters. And Tianjin University is a leading university in pioneering the emerging engineering education, which was proposed by MOE with the aim to adapt to the changes of times. The emerging engineering education has a profound emphasis on industry-university integration, cross-integration of different disciplines, domestic and international training integration, and active integration of teaching and research. With a 3E education center and Washington called the International Affairs Office established in 2018, and TJU Plan 2.0 released in 2020, Tianjin University expects to nurture competent and innovative future engineers. TJU places a considerable emphasis on international cooperation. We cooperate with over 200 partner universities and institutions in 50 countries and regions. Moreover, we have three overseas Confucius institutes which can help the local people learn more about the Chinese culture. And in September 2014, the nine elite Chinese engineering universities of the excellent alliance of universities and the eight Asian universities came to an agreement regarding a cooperation and exchange under the framework of AC9 Intech, laying a solid foundation for two sides' substantial collaboration to cultivate talents in the area of engineering and technology for China Asian countries. And as an international university, TGU has an international demonstration project, School of Pharmaceutical Science and Technology. SPST is very active in global engagement, having a number of international 40 postdoctoral fellows, exchange students from many different countries. In addition, the teaching language in SPST is English, and the students of SPST have many opportunities for going abroad during their studies. And now, TGU has received numerous accreditations from prestigious higher education recognition organizations for its outstanding work in education. These partnerships also allow us to continually improve the quality and content of our curriculum so that our students receive an education that is effective and highly result-oriented. This slide shows some of our programs that are accredited by some of the world's most prominent international accrediting bodies. And with strong academic background and excellent student quality, TGU has established friendly cooperative relations with many well-known enterprises to provide lots of internship and employment opportunities for students. And through 127 years, TGU has cultivated more than 300,000 graduates, and a big number of them has become our famous alumni. They are scientists, educators, economists, policy leaders, engineers, architects, mentors, and others. They devote themselves to building China into a stronger country and also contribute a lot to the progress of science in the world. And nowadays, a lot of outstanding alumni of TGU are active on the front line of various industries, such as architecture and civil engineering. They were responsible for the design and construction of most of the major venues for 2008 Olympic Games, G20, and APEC meetings. And this page also shows some international alumni of Tianjin University. They are active in the embassy and other famous firms in the world. So if you want to embrace a bright future as they do, we warmly welcome you to join us, as TGU is home to a wide variety of top-ranking programs. We provide both degree programs and non-degree programs. Most bachelor programs are 4 years in duration, and a master program 2 to 3 years, and a PhD program 4 to 5 years. This chart shows the tuition fee and application timelines. We strongly encourage early applications due to the limited places. And to facilitate the study for international students, we offer English-taught programs. There are in total 4 bachelor programs, 27 master programs, and 52 doctoral programs conducted in English. For some programs, you will have opportunities to attend a class with local Chinese students. And the significance of Tianjin University programs is that if we compare with some other top universities, our tuition fee is much cheaper and will ease you and your family's financial burden. Please look at this chart. For the bachelor programs, our tuition fee is only $2,460, which is nearly one-fifth of other universities. Even in China, TGU is quite affordable when compared with the institutions in Beijing and Shanghai. Besides, our non-degree programs are also very popular among students, so let me introduce some of them. Well, foundation program is designed for beginners who plan to study science or engineering to have a systematic study of Chinese, basic mathematics, physics, and chemistry. By learning our foundation program, you can make a good preparation for your degree program. What's more, you will also have more opportunities to get our scholarships. On the right shows two of our outstanding foundation program graduates. The Chinese language program is open to international students who love Chinese language and culture. Students can improve their Chinese language level by these courses. And if you are not able to commit a full semester of or year at TGU, then our short-term programs are highly advised. They usually occur during the summer or winter vacation, when the schools will arrange a well-scheduled program, which you will experience an interactive program, including classes, group discussions, case studies, and learn about the cultural aspects in China and gain practical real-world experience. And as I said earlier, the tuition fee of Tianjin University is quite competitive. However, we still provide various scholarships to reduce the financial pressure of students. For PhD, besides Chinese government scholarship, we have Paying Future Scholar Scholarship. The tuition subsidy is 38,000 RMB per academic year, which can cover most majors. You even have a few thousand RMB to add to your living cost. To some extent, the coverage and standard is a bit higher than Chinese government scholarship. And for master programs, besides Chinese government scholarship, we also provide Tianjin Government Scholarship, International Chinese Language Teacher Scholarship, and Tianjin University Scholarship in School of Civil Engineering and Technology. And for bachelor program, I would like to highlight Tianjin University International Student Scholarship and Qiushi Scholarship. Tianjin University International Student Scholarship is a one-year duration scholarship and has four types. If you got type D in your first year, you still have chance to get type A in the following year if you study hard and get good grades. Real Qiushi Scholarship is a full-time scholarship offering the tuition subsidy of 20,000 RMB per academic year. If you choose to study the English taught program of chemical engineering, Tianjin University Scholarship in Chemical Engineering is also a good choice. Besides financial assistance, TGU is providing other supports. During the fight against the epidemic, TGU researchers have made great contributions. For example, our intelligence security team designed the information registration system for people returning to Tianjin, which could scientifically predict the flow of passengers and quickly register using artificial intelligence technologies to establish a traffic flow prediction model. The research team in School of Life Sciences invented a novel coronavirus pneumonia antibody test kit, which could make detection in 15 minutes. Well, our staff in SBST produced a wearable wireless health monitoring device and will effectively reduce demand for the medical staff from mild cases. And even our students from School of Architecture and Medical College came up with a code scanning handiwork, which saved our medical staff from suffering during freezing days when collecting information. So after learning our Tianjin University and Tianjin the city, so how is life in TGU? So first, I will show you our campuses. We have mainly two campuses. Weijing Road campus is in the center of city and 20 minutes away from several beautiful attractions and the big shopping malls. And the Paiyang Park campus is our new campus, about 25 kilometers from the Weijing Road campus, but there are two new subway stations nearby. Both are about 3 minutes walk away. And this slide shows our Weijing Road campus, which is a garden-style campus with a lot of trees and lakes. You will find many classical buildings in there. And these pictures are taken on Paiyang Park campus, which is a quite modern style and brand new campus. And now let's turn our attention to the facilities. We are proud to tell that the university has made numerous investments in research facilities in order to train a new generation of scientists who can dive into experimental work to purify their studies. We have in total four national key labs, eight provincial or ministerial level labs, and many other research centers. And we also have many state-of-the-art campus infrastructure, like a aquatic center, library, even fond of online shopping, the autonomous express cars that are equipped on campus will deliver parcels to your dorm directly. So in terms of accommodation, we provide sufficient rooms for students to choose freely. All the accommodation are well located, with easy access to teaching facilities. As for the room types, we have single rooms, twins rooms, and also a few triple rooms. It's a laundry room, kitchen, and the bathroom shared for use. Air conditioning, Wi-Fi are also provided. The monthly rates for rooms ranging from 750 to 1,800 RMB, according to the room type you choose. TGU has many canteens, including pure Muslim canteen on both campuses. International students will taste different kinds of delicious Chinese dishes, rice, noodles, dumplings, hot pots, and so on. There are also coffee houses and fast food restaurants providing snacks such as fried chicken, macaroni, and cheese for international students. All kitchen staff have health certificate and wear face masks at work time. Plates, spoons, chopsticks, desks, chairs are disinfected every day to ensure the cleanliness. So, how to make the most of your time at university? Attending activities is a good way, as you will have a chance to meet different people and learn more about the culture. TGU holds various activities every year for students to join. Take paying lecture as an example. As a brand lecturer established since 2002, it has invited leaders like Denmark's Prime Minister, Australian Prime Minister, and well-known professors like Nobel Prize winners, famous writers, and entrepreneurs, and hold more than 320 lectures, which has benefited students in many ways. And international students are also able to get involved with as many as 160 other activities and communities, like International Cultural Festival, Begonia Flower Festival, Robot Festival, and others. And so after through the introduction about Tianjin University, it's time to share the very important information on how to apply to Tianjin University. So before you apply, please make sure you meet our qualifications. You shall be non-Chinese citizens with a valid passport by under the age of 30 for bachelor program and 35 for master program and 40 for doctoral program. If you're able for Chinese taught programs, you need to submit HSK certificates with the requirement various according to different majors and programs. If you apply for English taught programs, you need to submit English proficiency certificate like IELTS, TOEFL, or Duolingo. Native English speakers could exempt from providing relevant certificates. So, if you meet our qualifications, please prepare the following documents and upload onto our application system. Be noted that any insufficient documents may result in failure in application. And then, follow our application process and finish the application step by step. Open an account in our application system first and fill in all the information and upload the required documents. International Admissions Office will give the preliminary review, and if your documents are sufficient, then the schools and the professors will make the academic evaluation. Those who pass the evaluation will receive an interview invitation, and the final admission and scholarship result will be released after the interview. Please bear in your mind to pay close attention to your email and the message box of application system to ensure you will not miss anything important. So during the application process, you do not need to charge any application fee. So please do not hesitate to apply to Tianjin University. Okay, thank you for listening to today's presentation. If you have any questions about the application or scholarship, you may reach out to us by either sending emails or following our social media account like Instagram, Facebook, WeChat, or just logging on to our website where FAQ robot Hai Xiaotang will respond 24 hours, 7 days. Of course, you may also turn to our international student ambassadors for help and get valuable advice. Okay, thank you for listening and hope to see you soon at Tianjin University and have a good day. And in the final page, there is a WeChat QR code of our application group. So now you will have maybe 1 to 2 minutes to use WeChat to scan the code and join us. So if you have any questions about application or scholarship later, you can ask freely in the group. Our student ambassadors and admission coordinators will answer your questions as soon as possible. And after 1 to 2 minutes, I will invite our student ambassadors of Tianjin University, and she will introduce her study and life experience at TGU. Okay, so first you can scan the code now, and after that, I will invite our ambassador.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Gizia Murli Janti. My Chinese name, Lai Mizhen. I'm a master student of Tianjin University. I'm also an ambassador of Tianjin University in 2023. I would like to give some information, experience from my which I studied in Tianjin University. Okay, wait. Okay, so first of all, welcome who student to interest study in the university or already apply in the university. And for me, studying abroad is everyone's dreams and is the process of making that dreams come true that many people are willing to fight. In realizing dreams, everyone has their own way and process. Okay, so I will share about my background. I'm from Indonesia. I was born in a capital city. This is my high school from Smak 7 Penabur, Jakarta. I'm graduate 2016, and in 2016 2017 I studied Chinese language in Huazhen University, Xiamen City. And 2017, I enrolled in Tianjin University as a bachelor student and graduate in 2021 with a Chinese government scholarship, which is a secret program. And 2021, I'm also enrolled as a master student on September with a Chinese government scholarship. So currently, I'm a master student, and this is my last year. And hopefully I can graduate this year. Okay, so why should to study at Tianjin University? So from history, Tianjin University is founded in 1895, which is the oldest institution of the higher education in China in the modern city history of China. And what's the achievement? Tianjin University has been selected as one of the first university of Project 211 and Project 985 and a Class A University of Global Tier 1 University Initiative in China. And already our admission, our teacher in the international office already give a ranking about Tianjin University in 232 and in the world. And what will you get if you enrolled in Tianjin University. So you will get growing reputation, international recognition, a comprehensive in-training programs and transferable skills, advanced research infrastructure, career growth, and advanced research facilities, heavy government funds for the international students, and also have a massive global mindset. So I will share my experience. This is my first day that I come to Tianjin University, which is this is my bachelor degree. I entered 2017, and my teacher, she is from environmental department, and she invited me, special invited me to economic faculty of economics, and get some webinar because I'm very interested in economics, also environmental. And this is our, because I'm from Indonesia, and we have some student in Tianjin, but also not Tianjin University, also not only in Tianjin University, but from every university in Tianjin. And here have kids in here, so foreigner kids. So I took a picture with her. So fun for me. And next, this is my second year, 2018 until 2019. I can hang out with my friends also, have go out, hang out. We are Indonesian students to hang out together, to play skiing. And there's a city in Tianjin, there are some shopping malls, something like that. And this is my birthday, my Indonesian student, that they give me some surprise. It's really, I mean, if you feel alone here, how I can survive, I don't have a friend, so don't worry. Every student here very warm, very welcome with you. And also this is attend my last of my third year. I will attend for summer school. It's really interesting for 1 week, and a lot of degree have this is my friends. They are have a bachelor degree already ongoing for PhD and also master degree. And in my bachelor degree, it's a really great experience that international office that they had some competition for foreigner. It's like a speech competition. It's really great honor for me. And this is not only for Indonesia, but all of the country. Also, and I'm so sad that have some COVID, like have pandemic, but we need to going back, but have some students still stay and prefer to going back. And maybe almost 3 years to study online. But for me, it's not an obstacle, but because in the pandemic situation, I can still have some work that I selected as an ambassador of Tianjin University in 2021, and I got the third prize winner. And also in 2021, I'm also graduate, like finally I'm graduate from Tianjin University as a bachelor student. I got Bachelor of Engineering. By the way, I'm not in English taught, but I'm Chinese taught. It's hard enough for me, but I can't graduate on time. It's really good. And this is my classmate from my first year until fourth year. All the Chinese student, and I graduate in my country. Yeah. Also, in the same year, in September 2021, I enrolled my master degree also in Tianjin University, because like I really like the vibes in Tianjin University. I really like the professor. It's really nice. They're very kind, and you know, like the facility of online study is really. I can study very, very well. I mean, like instead have a different time there. So I think it's not some obstacle for me. And finally, last year in October, I can going back to China, but I need to go to Guangzhou first for First, like to quarantine, like maybe 10 days, 7 days, and then others day for the quarantine, I going to Tianjin, like to finish the rest of my quarantine day. And that's all my experience until now. And today I'm already in dormitory in Tianjin University. It's really good, and I can write my thesis, continue my thesis, and hopefully can graduate this year. That's all. Then thank you for the listening. If you want to ask something or relate about the Tianjin University or scholarship or program, you can reach me through my WeChat. This is my WeChat, Instagram, and you can see my YouTube channel. There is a speaker. I invited some student to give their place to give some speech for their experience. Thank you. That's all for me.
Thank you. Thank you for the impressive sharing. And now I will answer some questions. Actually, another outstanding ambassador, Dasha, has answered most of the questions. Maybe I will answer some of them directly. So first is about acceptance letter. Actually, acceptance letter, it's better for you to get an acceptance letter from the professors of Tianjin University. But if you can't get an acceptance letter, you can also apply directly to TGU. And we will help you to find the suitable professors. This is the first point. And another point is about application fee. So during our application process, you don't need to pay any application fee. You just need to pay 420 RMB after your admission, and when you register, you need to pay the fee. And some students ask about the document list, application documents list, and I will share my screen. And so you can make a screenshot of this page. And this page shows all the documents you need to prepare in advance and submit these documents to the TDU application system. You can make a screenshot. Application fee is 420 RMB, but you do need to pay this fee during your application process. Yes, students can leave out campus. And another student asked about the QR code of WeChat group. You can scan this QR code to join us. And if you have any questions about application, scholarship, or other things, you can just ask freely in the group. And our admission coordinator and also our outstanding students ambassador will answer questions as soon as possible. You don't need to send hard copy documents to TGU. Actually, we have, yes, online only. Yeah, our ambassador has answered questions. Just send documents, materials to our system. Do you offer ticket if I guess scholarship? It depends on which scholarship you will have. You know, for MOC, which is the CIC Type A scholarship, you don't need to pay the ticket. But for other scholarship you need. Sorry, we don't have the clinical medicine in bachelor. We don't have this major. We have the medical college, You know, the attaché has sent the documents about the discipline list in the chat box. You can download them and choose your interesting majors or disciplines. And in this page, this is our international student service system. And this is a website, so you can upload your documents, materials, and fill in the personal information in this website. Okay. So it's the IELTS compulsory to apply at the university. Actually, it depends on which country. Actually, you know, if your previous degree program was taught in English, you can ask the previous like university to provide a certificate of English taught. In previous, and you can provide this. But if not, you need to provide IELTS or TOEFL Duolingo scores. And this shows the language proficiency requirement. Also, if you are from the English country, you don't need to pay. You don't need to provide any others. Yes, about the interview. Interview is after the preliminary evaluation of International Admission Office. Yes, you can apply at the same time, but you will get one scholarship. Yeah, so please feel free to apply. Yeah, so you can, and lastly, you can scan the code. And if you have any questions in the future, you can ask freely in the group. Yes, you can apply for two scholarships at the same time, but you will get one scholarship in final. My advice is, you know, the two reference letter. So I'm not sure, does he or she hope to apply for CS Type B bachelor program, right? Actually, as I know, TGU, you know, CSC Type B is only for master or doctoral program. It's not for bachelor program. Yeah, so maybe you need to check the program. If you hope to apply for bachelor program, you can apply to CSC Type A or like some Tianjin University scholarship like this one, you know, for Tianjin University International Students Scholarship, 求是 Scholarship. Maybe the last question of today's presentation. Can I apply multiple scholarship? Yes, you can, but you will have get one scholarship. And do I need to learn 1 year Chinese program? Actually, it depends on the HSK certificate of you. If you can guide HSK 5 or 4 about 180 scores, you don't need to. How much duration for master degree? It is most about 2 years, or some is 2 years and a half. So it depends on which majors. You can download a discipline list according to the chat box. Okay. Thank you.
He said, I'm not a law. 现在是主持人不允许我在会议中开启视频。好了 ，Thank you. Yeah, just give me 1 second to share my screen with you guys. Okay, here we go.Okay. Hello, everyone. My name is Karen Chang from the School of Economics at Shandong University. So, on behalf of my school, I'm here to introduce the international program that we specially offer for you guys. So, to begin with, please allow me to share a 3 minute video with you to give you a brief sense about Shandong University.
Shandong University is one of China's largest and most prestigious universities, with a rich academic heritage that dates back over 100 years. Founded in 1901, we helped lay the foundation for China's modern education. At present, Shandong University is part of a national plan to elevate China's tertiary education to world-class status. Shandong University is located in the cultural heartland of China and the birthplace of Confucianism.Here, 70,000 students from across China and around the world pursue academic excellence with leading experts in one of China's largest universities. The beautiful environments of the university provide an ideal environment for living and learning, with sea or mountains surrounding the impressively modern and vibrant campuses. Shandong University educates academic leaders and world-class thinkers hungry for knowledge and experience.We also foster well-rounded young adults with an emphasis on overall personal development, social responsibility, and the building of outstanding professional capabilities. With the motto of Shandong University being noble in spirit, endless in knowledge, the development of leadership qualities combined with an honorable mindset and community spirit is an extremely important part of academic life.Shandong University seeks to cultivate students who will flourish in many aspects to enrich and further the development of the global community. To help obtain a top quality education, students can apply for scholarships, which can be the deciding factor in turning ambitious dreams into reality. Thousands of alumni have realized a bright future with prestigious jobs and enviable salaries. Graduates can look forward to even better employment prospects as the caliber of Shandong University's faculty continues to increase in breadth and depth as more outstanding professors come to lecture and do research here. At Shandong University, you will have the opportunity to learn outside of the classroom. Go and explore Shandong's seaside and beachside resorts. Experience ancient traditions, discover cultural icons, and immerse yourself in China's dynamic cities. From the Yellow River to the Great Wall and the Terracotta Warriors, we strive to unify ancient traditions and modern-day education to shape the talents of tomorrow. Noble in spirit, endless in knowledge, we welcome you to Shandong University.
Okay, thanks for watching. So in the following time, I'm going to talk about the location of our university, then some key facts and figures about how good we are, and the program details about international program, and finally, some pictures about campuses and student life here. First, location. So here you see the map of China like a rooster, and the right spot here is where we are. So Shandong University is located in Shandong Province, which is the birthplace of Chinese civilization and also as the hometown of Confucius and Mencius. We rank the third largest province in China in terms of GDP, and in terms of population, we rank the second largest province. On the right panel over here, this is the map of Shandong Province, and that is Jinan. So where Jinan is the capital city of Shandong Province. And Jinan has another beautiful name as the city of springs because we have 72 natural springs located in Jinan. So in Jinan, Shandong University has 6 campuses, including the School of Economics. And in Qingdao City, we have another campus. And in Weihai City, we have another one. So together, Shandong University has 8 campuses located in 3 different cities in Shandong. Okay. At Shandong Province, we have many world-famous places of interest. First of all, that I want to talk about is the Mount Tai. So Mount Tai is one of the highest and the most beautiful mountains in China, and it's very close to Jinan. It's going to take you about 1 hour by driving or 20 minutes by train to get there. So it's super easy for you to plan a day trip to go to Mount Tai for hiking and climbing. And the second one is Qingdao City. As I mentioned, Qingdao is a beautiful coastal city in Shandong Province. It is famous for its Qingdao beer and also as a co-host city of 2008 Olympic Games together with Beijing. So you can go to Qingdao for swimming and diving, of course, enjoying Qingdao beer in the hot summer days out there. And last but not least is Qifu. So Qifu is the hometown of Confucius. If you want to explore the traditional Chinese culture and see the ceremonies, that's the right place to go. Okay, more about the location of Jinan. So here is the Jinan, and here is the Beijing, and here is Shanghai. It takes you about 1.5 hour to travel from Beijing to Jinan, and 3.5 hour from Jinan to Shanghai. So super convenient. Got you some nice pictures about the night visions of Jinan City. So this is the CBD area. This is the Daming Lake right in downtown, and that is the downtown area of Jinan. Those are the pictures about Baotou Springs. Just right in downtown, we have this fantastic place. So what I can say about Jinan City, that Jinan is a modern city with full of cultures and history and a lot of natural resources in and around it. Now let's move to the university part. Shandong University was established in 1901 with over 120 years history that make us to be the second established university, national university in Chinese history. We are not only one of the top ranked comprehensive university in China, but also listed in the double first class university program by the Ministry of Education. According to the recent ESI World Ranking, we got 18 subjects being listed in the top 1%, and 5 subjects of them have been listed in the top 1,000. Together, we are very confident to say that Shandong University is becoming one of the world's best universities in the near future. Some key facts and figures. So at Shandong University, we have over 41,000 full-time undergrad students and over 24,000 master and PhD students and over 1,600. May I continue? We got over 1,600 international students studying with us, and we have 45 doctoral programs, 51 master program, and 95 bachelor programs here. And in terms of full-time faculty members, we got over 4,500 of them, and we 21 of them are academicians. We also have 12 state scientific research platforms, 6 national talent training bases, and 19 Shandong University affiliated hospitals to serve our faculty, student, and community in a better way. Okay, for School of Economics, the international programs we offer for you cover all levels, bachelor degree, master, and PhDs. So for the undergraduate degree, we offer you a major in finance. For master degree, we offer you 3 majors, finance, international trade, and world economy. For PhD degree in economics, we offer you 3 majors here, finance, international trade, and public economics. Okay. All teaching and working language is English. And the model of instruction will be in person right now. If you have difficulty to come to China and sit in the classroom, we can deliver our lecture online. That's not a problem. Okay, some program details. The international programs we offer for you aim to train the future academic professionals and business leaders. They are designed only for the international students who intend to obtain advanced education in economics with all teaching and working language in English, as well as learning Chinese and Mandarin and experiencing multicultural lives with us. The courses are designed closely following the top business schools in North America, and all your professors hold PhDs degrees in the economics or finance from world-leading universities. So instructions with Asian perspectives, especially with many Chinese characteristics, makes our program unique and outstanding among other similar programs you see in China. So after graduation, we expect our students to find a decent job in the business industry or academic institutions worldwide, or pursue your future studies in leading universities worldwide. Here summarize at least the 3 reasons why you should study economics or finance with us. The first of all is that the courses are designed here will help you to equate both practical skills and as well as decent research capabilities required for both career markets as well as the future academic studies. Second is that we got about like 40 faculties at School of Economics who have obtained the PhD degree from leading universities in worldwide. And we all have rich experience and good teaching evaluation in teaching English, including myself. Last but not least, we have a very strong IT team. So we have a strong online support. So if you can come to China and study on campus, sit in the lectures, that's awesome. If not, that's not a problem because all our students can easily get access to all the teaching materials. And some of our English courses can be delivered in the public online class platforms. So program details, a bachelor degree in finance normally takes 4 years to complete. Those are the fundamental courses that are going to take, such as China survey, academic writing, mathematics, and you're going to learn Chinese Mandarin. And those are the major courses and some of the advanced major courses. And you do have the option to choose some elective courses as you wish. And in the final year of your undergraduate study with us, you're going to do your internship and write up your thesis for your graduation. Okay, for the master degree, it's going to take you 3 years. And a PhD degree normally takes 4 years to complete. And you see some similar courses as China survey and more advanced major courses compared with undergraduate program. Okay. But as a master student or PhD student, you're going to spend more time on your dissertations and sit in the advanced lectures, seminars to prepare for your defense or pre-defense, those kind of stuff. Okay. More advanced. Okay, some representative of the faculties here. First one is me, and this is Professor Wang. He got his PhD in economics from the UK. This is Professor Zhang. She got her PhD in finance from the Switzerland. This is my colleague, Professor Gao. He got his PhD in finance from the US. This is Professor Chang. She got her PhD from the in economics from the US. Again, we have about 40 faculty obtain overseas PhD degree in economic finance, and more than half of us have over 5 years English teaching experience at the School of Economics here. So we always encourage all our students, including Chinese students, as well as the international student, to obtain international exchange experience here. So currently, we have built up collaborations with over 30 leading universities from 20 different countries and regions, such as the UC Berkeley, University of Pennsylvania in the States, University of Queensland from the Australia, Tuberk University from the Europe, and blah, blah, et cetera. So we encourage our students to study abroad as exchange student out there. Besides, we established the international summer schools here. So at the summertime, we invite the professors overseas to come to China, come to Jinan, to give lectures to our local students here. So you do have another different experience or I say opportunities to meet the professor overseas, okay? Oh, here is another 7 minutes video I made with my colleagues talking about the School of Economics as well as international programs for you guys.
Shandong University is located in Jinan, the capital city of Shandong Province. As the second established national university, Shandong University has been one of the top universities in China ever since 1901. According to the recent ESR report, Shandong University is ranked ninth among thousands of universities and institutions in mainland China. The School of Economics offers a number of English taught programs, awarding bachelor degrees, master degrees, and PhD degrees. Our school is committed to providing students with very solid academic training and a great business experience, which will set them up for their future career successes.
Shandong University is a leading university in China with a very good reputation. For instance, anytime I travel out of China and I have to deal with immigration in Beijing, it gets a lot more easier because when I tell them I'm from Shandong University, they get more friendlier and start little conversation and tells me how great the school is.
Our bachelor program offered to international students consists both classical and modern concept in the field of international trade or finance. All the courses will be taught in English by our faculty who obtain PhD degree from top university in North America and Europe with specializations in e-commerce, international business, modern banking, and energy finance. Moreover, this program provides unique opportunities for international students to learn Mandarin Chinese as required courses. With multicultural living experience, I do believe that our bachelor program will definitely help you to become more internationalized and more competitive in your job hunting, and in your grad school applications as well.
This program is a special program that encourages foreign students and Chinese students to work together. So with our professors who are all trained overseas, we are all encouraged to think critically.
After I received several offers from German and European universities, I decided to go beyond average. So Shandong University is well-known and is one of the most prestigious. And it's more competitive in a global view. So I wanted to expand my career opportunities and make this country part of my educational journey.
So it's like 1 year I'm in China and I have lots of experience here. We have a safe place for study. And if we want to buy things in city center or other places, it's super easy to find because we have lots of different bus and we can also ride bikes.
We live in a very globalized economy, and globalization is growing year by year, and that makes international trade and finance very, very important. We have more than 100 international students, and you will get to know many of them. Of both the social professional network is something that is very, very important today.
I got many job offers from Chinese companies and national companies of Uzbekistan, and I got the job offer from Huawei in Tashkent, in the capital of Uzbekistan, and I'm so grateful for 3 years of education in China to the professors and teachers.
学无止境, 气有好人, 我在山东大学学习, 氛围很好, 我在山东大学参加了很多活动,
让我的中文水平提高。作为山东大学的老文留学生，我非常荣幸能够在这里提升自己的综合素质。希望我们可以在这里认识，欢迎大家来到山东大学。
Welcome to Shandong University.
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 Hope to see you here in the future,
so come and join us.
Thank you. Okay, application details. For the undergraduate program in economics, the applicants must be non-Chinese, and also you should be like at age of 18 or above. And by the time you apply, you should have a high school diploma. If not, just get a letter from your school, indicate like when you're going to graduate. And there is a minimum requirement for your English proficiency. You only need to meet one of them. For example, the IELTS test score to be 6 or TOEFL test score to be 80 or other proofs of equivalent English proficiency. Or the proof of language instruction if the highest degree program was taught in English. So as long as you can meet one of them, you're fine. Okay, and we expect our applicants to have a solid foundation in mathematics at high school level. For the master program applicants, similar requirement for the citizenship and other requirement for the English proficiency. And here we expect the applicant to have a solid foundation in mathematics at a college level. And for the PhD applicant, similar stuff, but here we expect the applicant to have a solid foundation, not only in mathematics, but also in the field of trainings in the economic or finance at a master level. Okay, fees, tuition fee. For the undergraduate program, the tuition fee is 26,000 Chinese yuan per year. And for our graduate students, the tuition fee is 32,000 Chinese yuan per year. There is a one-time application fee of 400 Chinese yuan. And the health insurance fee is about 800 Chinese yuan per year. And those are other living expenses. We just give you some idea about how much you expect in terms of accommodations and other food or other, you know, other personal spendings. It's quite subjective. Okay. Fundings, scholarships. So Chinese government offer you guys a full scholarship. That's what we call the CSC scholarship. So the CSC scholarship offered to international students covers tuition, accommodation, and the insurance fee in addition to the living subsidy. So because so good, it's very, very competitive. And it's only offered to the master and PhD program students and one by one road country students only. And the application deadline is March the 5th. So the deadline is coming soon. Be prepared. Okay. And if you cannot get the CSC scholarship for some reason, and every university also offer you scholarships, but this scholarship is partial scholarship to the international students. It covers all levels. So no matter you are doing the bachelor or the postgraduate with us, as long as you are an international student, that's fine. You can apply for Shandong University scholarship. And this deadline is a little bit later. That is the March, the end of March. Okay. So if you want to apply for our program, please submit your applications online through this webpage. And yeah, you can feel free to write it down or do a print screen of this slide. And you can find the program details about at the same webpage. And also you submit your online application or track your application status at the same webpage over here. Oh, fun time pictures. Okay. This is a picture of a central campus in Jinan. See the tall tower over here. That's where School of Economics locates. Okay. And there's another campus in Jinan. This is a picture about the Qingdao campus. This is another campus in Jinan. And Qingdao campus. Oh, sorry. That's Weihai campus. Qingdao campus. Okay. Multicultural community. Yeah. Before the COVID, we hold this on the annual basis. Yeah. Field trip, learning Peking opera. Yeah. International Cultural Festival.
Yeah.
Travel to Shanghai. And the Mang Tai. Suzhou. Tasting Qingdao beer. Yeah, Chifu. Playing soccer. Basketball. Yeah, photo show. Barbecue, learning Chinese Mandarin, sports games. Those are the picture about the student residence, the dorms. Okay, you can see this is a shared bedroom. You got the AC for the summer and also the central heating for the winter. You have your own bathroom. Okay, and you got the laundry rooms. And we got many cafeteria and dining house on campus. If you don't want to cook, just go there, grab the food. And if you don't want to cook, you have your own kitchens. Okay, contact information, very important. So phone number, email address. Yeah, but if you have any question regarding to the programs or the scholarship or even anything, visa applications, please feel free to call us or send us an email. Me and my colleagues, we are more than happy to help you guys out. Okay, we hope to see you in September. Okay, that's the end of my presentation. Thank you for your time. And next, I'm going to pass to my colleague from Weihai campus to continue with her presentation. And after that is the Q&A. Thank you. Okay, thanks.
Okay, thanks to my colleague in Jinan for sharing. This is Professor Xia, the Association Dean of Business School of Shandong University at Weihai. Good afternoon, teachers and students. Now I'd like to introduce our business school in Weihai campus. So we will introduce six parts. So why choose business school? What you can learn from here and who will teach you what we offer and how about the campus and and city life in Weihai and what's your future career like? Okay, this is our campus. Very beautiful, coastal, located in very beautiful coastal city, Weihai. And our business school founded in 1988. And this year is the 30 years anniversary cemetery will be held in October. And benefit from the beautiful natural environment advantage location and the education resources of Shandong University. Business School of Environment Advantage Location and the Education Resources of Shandong University. Business School offers undergraduate and postgraduate program for international students. And now the international students from different countries, including the Republic of Korea, Argentina, Russia, Thailand, and some other countries or regions. So we have the five major undergraduates for undergraduates and one double degree major, one bachelor degree minor, and two micro majors for undergraduate students. So the double degree major is international trade and English. The bachelor degree minor is financial. And we also have two micro major provided for the undergraduates of all the Weihai campus students. One is business data analysis, one is financial technology and financial standardization. And also we have two major for undergraduates. Four is the national first class undergraduate major, including finance, international economy and trade, business administration, and accounting. One major under the construction of new labor arts, that is supply chain management. So all the major provided for the international trade, including international economics and trade, and the business management to different direction. One is tourism and big data. One is digital marketing. So it's all the full-time, 4-year undergraduate studies. After you have finished it, you can get the Bachelor of Economics or Bachelor of Management. We also provide the study for the postgraduates. One is Applied Economics, one is Business Management. So 3 years for master degree and 4 years for PhD. So this is a major course for the international economy and trade. This is major courses for the business management direction at tourism and big data. So this is a major courses for business management, direction and digital marketing. And we also have some courses have won the provincial award, including the online and offline or online, for example, marketing, basic accounting, international trade, international investment, and also the industrial economics, etc. And we also have 11 online courses for MOOC, including marketing, basic accounting, supply chain management, human resources management, etc. So Weihai is very cool in the summer vacation. So we provide the international courses in the summer vacation for all the undergraduates, including Weihai campus, Jinan campus, and Qingdao campus. So every year, we have more than 20 international courses delivered by overseas famous professor. The professor from the United States, United Kingdom, Australia, Switzerland, Netherlands, Korea, etc. The international courses, including digital marketing, international business management, strategic planning in marketing, multiple criteria decision analysis, big data and machine learning, etc. So this is some pictures to show the summer school international courses. Okay, then next we introduce our teachers, professors. So we have the disciplinary faculty. And so the number in our school can bring the far-reaching academic collaboration from a wide range of disciplines, including economics and management. There are 30 professors, 45 associate professors, 11 doctoral supervisors, and 35 master supervisors. So 44% of them have overseas experience for more than 1 year. So this is some professors for the courses the international study students will study. For example, Professor Xia Hui in marketing, Professor Wei Wenzhong in marketing, Professor Gu Zhusha, so this is a professor in international economy and trade, Shen Jun, the professor in international economy and trade, Hu Nanpeng, the professor in business. Direction is tourism and big data. Han Guosheng, this is also the professor from the management of the tourism and big data. So what we can offer to you? So besides teaching, we also can provide the academic platform for undergraduates, graduates, etc. So this have the interdisciplinary collaboration in research based on development of applied economics and business administration discipline. We also have many projects, from the National Social Science Fund, National Natural Science Fund, etc. And we also established two major academic platforms in Northeast Asia Economic and Trade Cooperation and Cross-Border E-Commerce. The other is Marine Resources and Environmental Economics. We also have the Advanced Experimental Center of Economics and Management, which is a provincial experimental teaching demonstration center. With big data, cloud computing, and AI, VR, etc. So this is some pictures of our VR laboratory, including digital marketing, supply chain, or business data analysis, etc. Last year, we have moved to the new building. So our laboratory center will have more advanced equipment. And if you have joined us, you will find it. So next is we have the advanced academic research and also the very good award have earned by the undergraduates because they have got innovation and entrepreneurship educations during the undergraduate courses. So in recent 5 years, we have 32 students team have won the national award, including Challenge Cup, an international class competition. Some record is a new record in Weihai campus of Shandong University, for example. Okay, how about the campus and city life? So Weihai, just as we have shown, so this is a very beautiful coastal city surrounded by sea on three sides. So Weihai is a coastal city with the longest coastal line in China. The coastal line is about 1,001 kilometers. So our campus near the seashore, so it's a very beautiful international campus of Shandong University with mountains, lakes, forest, and the trees. So this is a very good place for your study and for your living. So this is the international exchange program we provided to the undergraduates and graduates students, including the international students. So the exchange program, including Oxford University, University of Birmingham, University of Western Australia, etc. So this is some academic lectures at our school. This is some Chinese cultural activity for the international students in our school. So what's your future career like? Maybe you are most interested. So international economy and trade, the career choice including International Economic Organization, Foreign Economic Department, multinationals, public institution, financial institution, governmental agency, etc. And also you can pursue a master and doctorate degree. So the career choice for business management, direction at tourism and big data, including tourism administrative department, travel agency, for example, C-Trip or booking, etc. And tourism consulting company, e-commerce company, governmental agency, etc. This is a career choice for the digital marketing, including corporate strategy research, market research and planning, sales management, CRM, digital marketing management, and also can pursue a master and doctoral degree. So you can contact us at your convenience. And also you can visit our official website. Welcome to Business School of Shandong University. We are waiting you here. Okay, thank you. If you have any question, you can ask. And my colleague will can also for you.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear.
Okay, so my name is Anas, and I'm from Pakistan. Recently, I have done my bachelor's in clinical medicine from Jining Medical University in Shandong Province. And now I have applied for a master's in social medicine and healthcare management in Shandong University. My question is that I have a research publication, but it's not yet published. So I want to ask that, is it helpful to get to help me get the university scholarship? Because my research paper is not yet published, but it is, but maybe it will be published after maybe 1 month or 2 months. But I have already submitted my application for master's in social medicine and healthcare medicine.
Okay, thanks, Anas, for your questions. And you can visit our official website. There have the email for every professors, and you can write an email and provide it your papers and discuss your plan. If you can get the approval, then you can apply for our programs. Okay.
I have already applied for master's. I have submitted my application. I just need information that if I have the research publication, is it helpful to get admission?
Maybe my colleague can answer your question. Yeah.
Okay.
Teacher Lee.
Lee老师不在。哦，我觉得他不在。
在吗？
I'm here, Professor Xia. Thank you. Yeah. I think the student is applying for Jinan campus.
Yes, right? I'm applying. I apply for Jinan campus.
Yeah, and you have already submitted your application, right?
Yes.
Now please wait for the answer, because our application will be.Has just started, and the duration is from, let me see, you're applying for master degree, right?
Yes, I applied for master's.
You can wait for another 2 months.
Okay. What is the university scholarship? Is it cover the tuition and hostel fees, and is there any stipend in the university scholarship or not?
The university offers several kinds of scholarships. You can visit the website. Some of the scholarships, like Shandong University Freshman Scholarship, can cover your tuition.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you. Are there any questions?
No, I just wanted to know, because I had a research publication. My brother is in Shanghai, 九通大学, in Shanghai. Mm-hmm. And he's doing PhD, and I was working on him in his research. So I was asking that is that research publication will help me win the scholarship for Shandong University or not? This is my question.
Hello, I will answer your questions. Because you have applied the master degree in our university, right? And
yes.
I think your paper documents, your research the paper is very useful to be admitted in our university. But if you don't have, you can upload the abstract of your research paper.
Yes, I uploaded the abstract and
the other stuff. You have uploaded, it's okay. And when the professor review the documents, they will check your documents.
Okay, I got it. And one more question. I have done my bachelor's from Jining Yishu Yuan in Shandong province. And Jining Yishu Yuan is not English medium. It's bilingual. So the language proficiency certificate we got is like all the courses we taught are both in English and Chinese medium. So it's not a English language proficiency certificate. But I already also uploaded that document as well. Also my IELTS certificate as well. My IELTS score is 6 overall. So overall score is 6. So is it acceptable?
You mean your medium in English and Chinese, right?
Yes, my bachelor's degree medium, the university medium was English and Chinese. But I also have the IELTS certificate with overall band 6.5.
Yes, it's okay. You can upload.
Okay. Thank you so much.
But your English, your medium or bachelor should be taught in English is better. Because you said you some courses you taught in Chinese. This cannot meet our requirements. If you have the IELTS or TOEFL, it's okay. You can upload.
So it's like this. For Jining Medical University, we learn all the medical courses in English. But you know, but the university is bilingual. So they issued the language proficiency certificate, the bilingual certificate. But we have learned everything in English. That's not a problem.
Yes, it's okay.
Yeah.
He has the IELTS test, which is good enough. So.
Yeah, my IELTS score is 6.5, and
that's good enough. The minimum requirement is 6. You got a 6.5. That's good enough.
So you know, my overall IELTS score is 6.5, but the score for reading is 5, and listening and speaking is 7.5. Is it fine that if in one module in reading I have like 5, but overall score is 6.5?
It's hard to tell right now because it depends on your competitors, right?
Yeah.
So there is no like a cutting off point. It's hard to tell. It depends on your competitors, right? But as professors, we're gonna evaluate all our applicants to consider like everything from different perspectives, like such as your GPA, your IELTS test, and your research ability, etc. So it's a very comprehensive evaluation. So it's hard to tell. Okay.
Okay. Okay. I got it.
Yeah.
I think. And do you offer any Chinese language courses, like one-year non-degree Chinese language courses? Hello?
Hey, hello. I will answer your questions. Yes, we have the one-year Chinese language course, but it will open in March.
Yes, I because right now I'm in my country, so I already applied for master's in Shandong University, so I want to come back and learn Chinese for 6 months, and after, if I get acceptance, I just want to change my visa to my master's degree. So is it possible that we can apply right now?
But if you have applied in the system, you cannot apply the second time.
Okay, I got it.
Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to join the presentation of Wuhan University. And I'll just start the presentation right now. As you can see, this is the location of Wuhan University. It's just the middle in China. It's very convenient for you to go to Shanghai or Beijing. For you to take the high-speed train, it only takes around 3 or 4 hours. Wuhan University was established in 1893 as Zhejiang Institute and has a long history with almost 130 years. For 2023, it's the 133 years anniversary of Wuhan University. I wish that all of you can join Wuhan University and to celebrate the 130 years birthday of Wuhan University. Wuhan University is also honored as one of the most beautiful universities in China. As you can see, the old architectures and the environment here in Wuhan University is very, very beautiful. And this is the campus view, and this is the Zhongnan Hospital. It's only for medical students to study there. This is the cherry blossom. For the education that Wuhan University is creative, innovation, and entrepreneurship. The faculty and staff, we have a full-time faculty, 3,737. And for international faculty, we have 1,092 international faculty. We are the member of the Chinese Academy of Science, ranked 8, members of the Chinese Academy of Engineering, ranks 8, and winners of National Outstanding Youth Science Funding, ranks 47, and a Professor of Qigong Scholar Program, ranks 67, and a Senior Professor in Humanity and Social Science, ranks 10, and a National Outstanding Teachers, ranks 15, and in the middle part, that is the cherry blossom in March. And if you can come to Wuhan University in 2023, and you can enjoy the cherry blossom at Wuhan University. And for Wuhan University, we have a 122 undergraduate programs and 342 master degree programs and 248 for PhD programs. And besides, we also have a million in volumes in the library and 35 schools and departments and 3 affiliated hospitals and 71 state level quality courses and 38 centers for postdoctoral studies and a non-national experimental teaching demonstrating centers. And for students, we have 30,000 and 1,888 undergraduate students and 23,000 and 366 postgraduate students. And for international students, we have 3,119 international students. And we also encourage a student to think, innovate, and dream bigger. For international students to study in Wuhan University, we have 124 bachelor degree programs for international students and 347 for master degree students and 243 for doctoral studies at Wuhan University. And for the courses in English taught programs, we have electronic and compute engineering and compute engineering, software engineering, economics, clinical medicine, which is also called MBBS, management, nursing, communication, electronic commercial, And for graduate degree in English taught programs, we have international law, software engineering, clinical medicine, international business, geospatial information technology program, international master of business administration, electronic commercial, journalism and communication. And besides the degree study, we also have a non-degree study program for Chinese, for those who want to study Chinese at Wuhan University. And for the duration and the tuition fee, and you can see the PowerPoint here. For one semester, the tuition fee is 8,500 Chinese yuan. And for one school year, the tuition fee is 17,000 Chinese yuan. As far as I know, that a lot of international students are interested in Chinese government scholarship. At Wuhan University, we also provide Chinese government scholarship for master and PhD degree study. And to apply this scholarship, you need to apply at CSC portal. And at the same time, you need to finish the online application at Wuhan University at this website. And we don't require you to, we don't need the hard copy, so you don't need to worry about this. You can only submit your online application form and at CSC portal and the Wuhan University's portal. And we will check your documents first, and then we will let you know. If you are admitted at Wuhan University, we will email you back very soon. For the Chinese language scholarship, and you can choose Confucius scholarship, which is also the coverage, which also you can have tuition fee waiver and a free insurance and a free accommodation, and you can also get the living allowance, which is 3,000 yuan. RMB per month for master degree, and it is very convenient for you to study at Wuhan University. For you to obtain this to get this scholarship, Confucius scholarship, you need to obtain a bachelor degree and at least with HSK 5 certificate with scores 180 or above. And with the HSKK certificate, intermediate level HSKK certificate, and at least 50 scores or above. So this is for you to study Chinese language at Wuhan University. And also we offer 1 year Chinese language study for international students. And the scholarship coverage is free tuition fee, free insurance, and a free accommodation. And you can get 700 Chinese yuan for per month. And the per month for the living allowance is 2,500 per month. And to get this scholarship, you need to have a HSK 3 certificate and with scores 180 or above. And to hold an HSKK certificate, a beginner beginner level certificate with schools 60 or above. For one semester Chinese language scholarship, and you need to have a HSK 2 certificate with schools 120 or above. And hold with HSKK beginner level certificate with school 40 or above. And for the durations and for master's, it's 2 years. For 1 year Chinese language is for 11 months. For one semester, it's for 5 months. So if you want to apply for Chinese language scholarship or Confucius scholarship, you can take a screenshot here and get in and more information about Shandong University. So you may be wondering how to apply for Wuhan University. And to apply for the scholarship that I just mentioned above, the deadline is February the end, February to March the end. And you need to click this link, and this is the Wuhan University's link. This is CSE's link. And you need to finish the two portal not at the same time, but before the deadline. And here's the contact information of Wuhan University. If you have any other question, you can just call us and you can also email us. For you to apply for Wuhan University, you need to be a non-Chinese citizen. And you should be very friendly to China and have no criminal record and abide by the laws and regulations of the Chinese government and the rules and the regulations of the school. And there are things you need to have a good mental health condition and both in mental and physically. With a good record of academy performance and conduct. And aspiring to work in Chinese language education and religious field. So this is for you to apply for the Chinese language scholarship. And for the age limitations, it should be between 16 and under 35. For the applicants currently working as a Chinese language teacher, so not be over 45. So if you are going to apply for the Chinese language teacher or Chinese language scholarship, and this is very important, I wish that you can take a screenshot to prepare all your required document. For the scholarship and the qualification, and to apply for this scholarship for one semester, a Chinese language study, this program commences in February in 2023 and provides a scholarship of a maximum of 5 months. And applicants holding the X1 or X2 visa are not eligible. Applicants shall have a minimum score of 180 on the HSK test level 3, and on HSKK test score is required. And for the online program for one semester Chinese language study, commences in February 2023. Generally, applicants must have an HSK score, but not specific requirements for level or school scores. For online program for 1 year Chinese language study commences in February 2023, a general Chinese proficiency test score of 180 in HSK level 3 is required. And HSKK scores are preferred if you have. But if you don't have, and we will hold the online interview for international students. For the scholarship coverage and the criteria, and the scholarship provides a full coverage on the tuition fee, accommodation fee, living allowance, and comprehensive medical insurance expenses. And for the online programs, only provides coverage on tuition fee, so you don't need to worry about that. But since the borders are open, and you can come to China, and we will also provide you the accommodation and your living allowance. For more details, please contact us, or you can visit the link here to get in touch with Wuhan University, or to email us. So this is the application procedure and the documents that are required. And firstly, you need to register an account to admission.witu.edu.cn. And and to finish the online application before before May 15th for September intake. For 2024-3 March intake, you need to finish your application before October 31st. Please choose international Chinese language teacher scholarship, Chinese language student, and Chinese language student school of international, and the Chinese language student online program, school of international education of Wuhan University. And please submit your application on the International Chinese Language Teacher Scholarship application website at cis.chinese.cn. And from October 10th, 2023, sorry, this will be 2023 to November 5th, 2023. And this is for March 2024 March intake. For 2023 September intake, and you need to finish your application before May 15th. Assessment and admission. Wuhan University will review your application documents and organize interview for international students. And CL Chinese Language International College will entrust an expert panel to select scholarship candidates. And the final result will be published about 3 months before the school starts. So that means when you are going to apply for Wuhan University, you need to finish your online application as soon as possible so that we can arrange the online interview for international students and to evaluate all your documents. The policy regarding current employed Chinese language teachers and Chinese Bridge Award recipients and currently employed Chinese language teachers. Language teachers applying for the scholarship can be exempted from submitting Chinese language proficiency tests and certificates if they can provide a proof of employment and a letter of recommendation from the institution where they work. And secondly, for the Chinese Bridge Award recipients, applicants who have won the 2022 International Chinese Language Teachers Scholarship. Certificate in various Chinese Bridge competitions submit their application documents along with their scholarship certificates to relevant host institution on the International Chinese Language Teachers Scholarship website. For further inquiries, please contact the Chinese Bridge at chinese.cn. And you can also contact Wuhan University to get more information. For students who fail to pass the prior enrollment and medical examination and withdraw from school midway, or fail to report to school or suspend their studies without permission will be disqualified for scholarship. So this is the contact information of Wuhan University. And this is our official website for you to apply for. You can create an account. Or you can also email us, and we will get back to you very soon. So that's all for the presentation of Wuhan University. And now I'll share you the detailed information for Chinese language teacher programs. So this is the application guide for international Chinese language teacher scholarship for one semester or one academy year Chinese language study. And the purpose of satisfying the growing demand of international economy community for Chinese language teachers and facilitating Chinese language education in other countries. The Center for Language Education and Cooperation has set the International Chinese Language Teachers Program, Chinese Teacher Scholarship. Eligibility for this scholarship, you should be now non-Chinese citizen and should be friendly to China and have no criminal record and abide by the laws and the regulations of the Chinese government and the rules and regulations of the school. And you should be in good health and both mental and physically, and with a good record of academy performance and conduct. And you should aspiring to work in Chinese language education or related fields. And for the age limitation is 16. And so, 16 under 35 years old. Yes, and for this scholarship, you need to apply through the Wuhan University's portal, and I'll share the link later, and so that you can. The programs and qualifications. Scholarship for one semester study programs. The program commences either in September 2023 or March 2024 and provides scholarship of a maximum of 5 months, and applicants holding the X1 or X2 visa are not eligible. So for applicants of international Chinese language education, Chinese language and literature, and Chinese history or Chinese philosophy programs so have a minimum score of 180 on the HSK test level 3, and on HSK test score is required. Applicants of traditional Chinese medicine of Taiji or Taiji culture programs are required to provide HSK test scores. And yes, I will send you the link later, and and will be given to those who also provide in on HSKK test score. And for scholarship for one academy year study program, the program commences in September 2023. And a scholarship is provided a maximum of 11 months. And international students who have benefited from similar scholarship are not eligible. Applicants of international exchange language education programs will have a minimum score of 270 on the HSK test level 3, and HSKK test score is required. Applicants of Chinese language and literature, Chinese history, or Chinese philosophy programs will have a minimum score of 180 on the HSK test level 4, and 60 on the HSKK test intermediate level. Applicants of Chinese language study programs will have a minimum score of 210 on the HSK test level 3, and and priority will be given to applicants who provide an HSKK test score. The scholarship coverage is, the scholarship provides full coverage on tuition fee, accommodation fee, living allowance, and comprehensive medical insurance expenses. For more details, please visit our official link here at cris.chinese.com. And you can also contact Wuhan University for I'll just share the link to the chat box so that you can get in touch with Wuhan University. Or you can contact with this link. For the application procedure and application guidelines, the application will be available from March 1st, 2023. And so you can prepare your documents in advance and to submit your documents online later. And the deadline for this scholarship is from for programs commencing in September 2023, applicants must complete their applications by May 15th. And for program commencing in March 2024, the applicants must complete their application by November 15th. And for the required documents and you need to prepare a scanned copy, a passport copy, and a scanned copy of your HSK and HSKK test within the 2 years validity, and a reference letter by the head of the recommending institution. And in service, Chinese language teachers shall provide proof of employment and a reference letter from the employer, and applicants and 18 shall provide a certified document of designation signed by their entrusted legal guardians in China. So if you cannot provide this information, and I suggest you just write down your parents' information. That is also okay. And for applicants with study experience in China are required to provide their performance certificate. And this should be issued by the private university. So I think that is all for the Chinese language scholarship for international students. And this is the link for you to know more about Wuhan University. And we highly recommend you to contact us directly, because our staff in the International School of International Education will answer all your questions one by one, and we will email you back very soon. Okay, I think that is all for Wuhan University, and if you have any other questions, you can just ask me, and I'll answer your questions one by one. One of the students is asking that how to prepare recommendation letter. And for the recommendation letter, you can just ask your prior school to give you the recommendation letter and to get the recommendation letter, and they will sign their name on it with their email address. Yes, we do. I mean, Wuhan University does offer medical-related majors, nursing. And for the detailed information, you can just click the link below that I just shared in the chat box to get in touch with Wuhan University. We have the professional teachers, admission teachers in the office to answer your questions directly. For the prior admission letter, it's not mandatory for you to apply online. You can just submit your documents online, and we will review your documents. And after we check your documents, we will send you the final send you the result. If you are qualified, we will arrange the online interviewer for you to. Get more information about Wuhan University. There's one student is asking that this scholarship cover the travel expenses. Okay, let me share the screen one more time and you can check it. Okay, you can take a screenshot. Do you have any other questions? The application fee at Wuhan University is $100, and this is now refundable. The stipend for PhD is $3,500 per month. The deadline for Wuhan University is March the 1st for scholarship study. Okay, I think that is all for Wuhan University. If you have any other questions, you can click the link here to get in touch with Wuhan University. And you can also contact us by email. And I'll share the email address here. And for more details about Wuhan University, you can just contact us. And that is all for today's presentation about Wuhan University. And thank you so much. If you have any other questions, feel free to get in touch with us and we will answer your questions one by one. Thank you so much. That is all. And next, we will hold the Russia and Belarus session on 26th tomorrow. And hope to see you soon there. And bye-bye.